Welcome to Nalla Narasimha Reddy Educational Society's group of institutions. Myself, Suresh Kumar, Assistant Professor in Department of Civil Engineering. In today's lecture, I'm going to explain about photogrammetry. What is this photogrammetry means? Photo. The photo is nothing but picture, and grammetry means measurement. Therefore, together it is called as photo measurement. So if you see this picture, how these photos, the pictures can be taken from this instrument. So in today's lecture, outline is, we are going to discuss about definition of photogrammetry, principle of photogrammetry, uses of aerial camera and aerial photograph, scale of vertical and tilted photograph, ground coordinates, procedure of aerial surveying and photo maps and mosaics and stereoscopes. These will be discussed in this lecture. So we'll see now the definition. The definition is the surveying in which photographs taken from suitable camera stations are used to accurate measurements is known as photogrammetry. Whenever you are doing survey, in that survey, the photographs will be taken from the suitable camera stations are used to make accurate measurements is known as photogrammetry. Means generally this type of survey will be conducted where all these flood occurring areas due to rainfalls, heavy rainfalls, where the person, we can't reach that point, so we'll do this sort of surveying in the difficulty situations. Now we'll see the basic information of this photogrammetry. The mapping from aerial photo is the best mapping procedure at developed for most large projects. See, this type of mapping of aerial photos will be mostly useful for larger projects. We can't conduct for all the small projects because it is somewhat costly. So, use it successfully for map varying in a scale from 1:1 lakh, 1:120, which contour intervals as small as 1 foot. So whenever you are preparing this scale, whenever these maps are seen, that maps will be a scale of 1:120 with the contour interval. That is very small as your 1 foot. Okay, the how much the your foot distance will have, that much of interval will be taken to draw all these maps. Topographic map is the most common for UGS updated and done in this way. Use it to reconstruct a scaled three-dimensional optional model of a land's surface using a stereoplotter. So this is also used for the three-dimensional optical models. Okay, all this will be used in this photogrammetry. So uses of aerial photos, what are the uses of these aerial photos and how it will be useful in our practical and real life? Aid. What is meaning of aid? Geological investigations, soil survey, land survey, tax mapping, reconnaissance and military intelligence, urban Rigonian development, transportation, investigation, transportation investigations, quantity estimations, system erosions, etc. A mathematical method. See, all these for all these purposes, these aerial photos are used. How will geological investigation, how the soil, subsoil structure below the ground surface will know according to these aerial photos. Soil survey, even we can identify the what type of soil it is at a particular area. Land survey also we can done, tax mapping, reconnaissance, and military purpose intelligence also it can be used. A mathematical methods have been developed to make precise three-dimensional measurement from photos. Okay, here not only from the photos, here there is a mathematical methods also available to extract the data from the three-dimensional photos. Photogrammetric photo triangulation, three-dimensional positioning of survey station. Photos has been used to take geometric measurements of human bodies, artificial human hearts, large radio telescopes, ships, dams, buildings, and very accurate reproductions. All these purposes, these have been used for surveying purpose. In general, it is not economical for small projects. So, whenever you are doing projects based on the priority of a work, you need to see that whether the project is very important or very larger projects, because the cost which is invested in this surveying is more. So it cannot be economical when you conduct this type of survey for small projects. The cost break even point is somewhere between 30 to 100 acres depending upon a situations. Okay, the cost break point will be 30 to 100 acres depending upon a situation where what the data you want to extract from that photos. Photogrammetry can not be used successfully over the following types of terrain. So this cannot be used for following type of terrains. So wherever you want to use that purpose, it may not be possible. That may not be possible things are desert or plain areas, sandy beaches, and snow. The topograph has uniform shades with little texture. So when this is a type of things, we can't go for this photogrammetry. One more thing, deep canvas or high buildings that conical ground surface, also we can't use these photogrammetry. Areas covered by dense forest, the areas which will be mostly covered with full of trees, or where the forest, if you see Nallamulla forest, it is very dense. So when this dense forest, we can't conduct this photogrammetric survey. So here photogrammetry is known as aerial survey. Classification of photogrammetry, or what classifications we have that follow in photogrammetry, we'll see now. Terrestrial photography, aerial photography. Photographs are taken from fixed position on or near the ground. Whenever in this method, the photo graphs will be taken from a fixed position on ground or near to the ground, okay, we'll take the photographs. But whereas in aerial photogrammetry, the photographs are taken by camera mounted in aircrafts flying over the area. See, in aircrafts will consist of some high differential cameras. With the high differential cameras will take that photographs. That type of survey is known as aerial photogrammetry. Define the photogrammetry is a process of measuring images on photograph. Modern photogrammetry also uses radar imaging. Here radar imaging also, this latest photogrammetry are using electromagnetic energy detection and X-ray imaging called remote sensing. See, this remote sensing, RS, we call it as RS, RS and GIS. This is a separate subject in your 4-1 semester, where we are going to study especially what is this remote sensing and GIS. Regarding this, there will be a deeply explanation in throughout the subject. So in our subject, we got only a smaller part regarding this remote sensing and GIS. If you see this aerial camera, the photographs will indicate the pictorial representation of this aerial camera. How it will be? What is the inner cone, lens? These are the lens for that camera. Focal length, focal plane, take up reel, unfocused film reel. All this image, body, lens cone, all this will be the camera, aerial camera picture, parts of aerial camera. The types of aerial photographs. What are the types we have in these aerial photographs? The vertical photograph, axis of camera vertical is less than 3 degrees. Absolute photographs, axis of camera inclined to vertical line is greater than 3 degrees. Convergent photograph, photographs taken with a pair of camera with the axis inclined. Okay, all these are the types of aerial photographs what we'll take in real time. Okay, we'll discuss this, the principle of aerial surveying, in the next class. Thank you.